Muskies have been called the fish of 10,000 casts, but it doesn't have to be that way if you fish smart. This involves having a game plan and sticking to it. Jim Saric has utilized this approach to become one of the most successful professional muskie fishermen of all time. Let's join Jim to see how he develops a plan to fish new water.
If you're like me, I bet a lot of you really like to fish new water. And whenever you're fishing new water, you need to have a very systematic approach to doing it. And the approach or system that a lot of my friends and I use is called search and finesse fishing whenever we're going after muskies on a new body of water. Now, you may have heard the term run and gun fishing. It's similar to run and gun, only with search and finesse fishing, you have a specific approach, specific goals in mind, so you systematically can fish any kind of body of water anywhere in the country or across North America. What you want to do whenever you're fishing a new body of water is you take your map, you'd go ahead, you'd highlight maybe your top 5 or 10 spots, maybe go out and map them, and then get on the water and start fishing. Now, when you start fishing, you want to just go and use a lure that can cover water quickly. You're searching for fish. And when we're searching for muskies, what we're doing is basically we're trying to cover water. We're trying to locate fish, obviously, and catch them when we can. We're going to learn the structure as we're coming through, so we're going to know where little points and turns are. And if we can't catch active fish, we're going to find the fish that are neutral or negative, maybe get them to follow the lures, and we're going to come back to those fish, and we're going to finesse fish for those fish and get them. But you're going to start out by covering ground. And you need a lure, a search lure, that can cover ground quickly. And by far, one of the best search lures is a bucktail. You can take a bucktail, and you can cover ground very, very quickly with it. You can bring it in fast. I take my trolling motor, I put it on a pretty good speed, and I'm covering ground. I'm going to fish faster than I may normally fish coming through an area. I'm going to bring the bucktail in as I come through an area. Make sure you figure eight, just like you always do. You're searching and fishing fast, but you're not fishing sloppily. So what you want to do is you just want to cover ground and search and look for active fish. And again, what you're trying to do is you're trying to learn the water, you're trying to catch active fish, you're trying to locate negative or neutral fish, and just be ready and try to determine the pattern. You want to keep all your eyes, your ears, everything open, and be ready in what's going on around you. Because all these fish that follow or the fish that you catch are going to give you little clues to determining the pattern. And that's the big, big part of this search and finesse system. Another decent fish on a bucktail. Come on, baby. Staying down. Pretty good fish. Take off of my drag a little bit. Where are you? Oh, yeah. Nice fish. Oh, yeah. Look. All right. Just pounded with a bucktail. Staying down. Come on, fish. Oh, yeah. Just coming down this bank. The wind had been just pounding on this bank all night long. We got up, started fishing here first thing in the morning, and we haven't been out 10 minutes. Made contact with another nice fish. Just ate them. Same buck. Come on now. Oh, yeah. All right. Okay. See if I can kind of grab her here. She's just really a tough fighter here. Oh, yeah. Pretty fish. Every time I think she's done, she's telling me something different. I want to unhook you and let you go, but you got to be nice to me. Okay. There we go. I got her. Okay. Another fish in the bucktail. Oh, beautiful fish. Look at that. Just gorgeous. Gorgeous fish. I tell you what, when you're coming into some of these these new situations, new lakes like this, you just got to cover ground and look for the pattern. And so far, our pattern on this lake has been throwing bucktails against shallow rocks, shallow rock reefs, and shallow rock shorelines.
Got a deal.
Beautiful. When you've gone through and fished a bunch of spots, and you've searched for active fish, maybe you've been fortunate to catch a couple, or maybe what you've done is just raised a few fish, and maybe you know they're on rocks or they're on weeds. You're starting to develop the pattern. Once you've gone through and you've searched through the area, now it's time to slow down and finesse fish. It's really the second half of this system. You've taken 10 spots, now you have it maybe narrowed down to 2 or 3 spots that you've got fish on, and now you go back and you finesse fish. And you finesse fish with slower moving, more erratic retrieve lures. Like this jerkbait is a classic example. What these more erratic retrieve or finesse lures do is they stay in the strike zone longer. They give a fish more time to react. And so you have a greater chance of triggering a strike from a fish that may not have chased down a bucktail. He may have chased it, saw it, you know, swam away. Now you take an erratic lure, you put it in their face more, you give them more time to react, you finesse fish them, and now you can come back and you catch them. Now when you finesse fish, what you're gonna do is you're not fishing as fast. Remember, you've narrowed your spots down to a handful. You're gonna go back, you're gonna fish them slower and very systematically, and you're gonna fish the key spots that you learned where the fish were, and it may be a little point or a little turn. You're gonna kind of really key in on the spot, and you're gonna finesse fish slower in these areas and try to focus in on triggering those strikes from those fish that followed before, but you couldn't get the strike. Oh, you boiled on it. Here he comes, here he comes, here he comes. Didn't follow it, though. He's not here. That fish just boiled on that bucktail. I'm gonna switch up, slow down, and put this topwater bait on it. Just go with the slow retrieve on top of this fish.
We did it before. We missed it. We came up and just pounded it. Oh, yeah. Get me all wet here. So we went in with the bucktail on this fish. Missed it, came back with this topwater, moving a little bit slower, and he just pounded it. Okay, absolutely wild. Okay. Another pretty fish.
Hello.
Gorgeous spotted fish. Pounded that topwater bait.